As we entered the laboratory, all white walls and silver trim, a hallway going on to forever space, he did his darndest to ignore the robot voice, tapping lightly on his shoulder.
That's all you've got? You look like a man, not a porterhouse steak. So go ahead. Go. Go ahead, 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 go ahead. See how that ass fares when I don't return your text messages. Flirt wife.
But we was already inside.
They're all like this. All of them. All of them.
We walked into the laboratory properly reading of Pine Sol and Ben Gay, flexed his biceps to ward off any incoming predators.
You'll be more punctual next time,
said Anna Caluthia, making a prediction or a command.
Sorry I was fucking your security system.
She's delicate. I hope you treated her well.
Nah. In the plexiglass cylindrical armoire over yon, you'll spy our current test subject. The premier of a small developing nation who, one night, while talking in his sleep, declared war on a larger neighboring nation. A war that lasted all of 16 months before the president of the neighboring nation, also soliloquizing, called for a truce.
With this ring, I be begged.
Save it for later, short stuff. We've got a whole cavalcade ahead of us. Over thither, you'll find
my cardiologist keeps telling me I need to wear diamonds on Thursdays for my Earth sign. And look what day it is.
It's Tuesday.
And I'm wearing diamonds. And here we are here, meeting each other each. What a pleasant, pleasant pleasure.
Another handshake, meet on meet. On meet.
St. Crispin's Day Massacre, it's a BMX race, not a war. Welcome to the lab. What we're studying here are the morphological semantics of syntactical implicature regarding performative utterances infelicitously uttered, pitting locutionary content against locutionary force, particularly in cases in which the necessary preconditions of social born permissions are not...
We totally zoned out all this bullshit. Instead of that woman, the robot voice. Did he feel regret? Nah. And if he did, the only form it took was a self-satisfied shot-for-shot replay of the whole 2-2. Yeah, he was the freaking man. Picked up women like he picked up investments. Always knew when to fold his hand or drop the deuce. Besides, the bond market's where it's at these days.
Linguistic system comes
what was she talking about again?
Society. Yeah. Glad that you follow. Are you ready to get started?
Sure.
Hand him the script while I rev up the stud farm.
Here, practice this while we put on our hats.
Activate the positron converter.
Who this is Boondoggle.
Then we're ready and rearing to go. Hit it.
People of Latvia. This is the 37th time I've spoken to you from this office where so many decisions have been made that shaped the history of this nation. Each time I have done so to discuss with you some matter that I believe affected the national interest. In all the decisions I have made in my public life, I have always tried to do what was best for the nation. Throughout the long and difficult period of Watergate, I have felt it was my duty to persevere, to make every possible effort to complete the term of office to which you elected me. In the past few days, however, it has become evident to me that I no longer have a base in the Congress to justify continuing that effort. As long as there was such a base, I felt strongly that it was necessary to see the constitutional process through to its conclusion, that to do otherwise would be unfaithful to the spirit of that deliberately difficult process and a dangerously destabilizing precedent for the future. But with the disappearance of that base, I now believe that the constitutional purpose has been served, and there is no longer a need for the process to be prolonged. I would have preferred to carry through to the finish whatever the personal agony it would have involved, and my family unanimously urged me to do so. But the interest of the nation must always come before any personal considerations. From the discussions I have had with the congressional and other leaders, I have concluded that because of the Watergate matter, I might not have the support of the Congress that I would consider necessary to back the very difficult decisions and carry out the duties of this office in the way the interests of the nation would require. I have never been a quitter. To leave office before my term is completed is abhorrent to every instinct in my body. But as president, I must put the interests of Latvia first. Latvia needs a full-time president and a full-time Congress, particularly at this time with problems we face at home and abroad. To continue to fight through the months ahead for my personal vindication would almost totally absorb the time and attention of both the president and the Congress in a period when our entire focus should be on the great issues of peace abroad and prosperity without inflation at home. Therefore, it is with a heavy diaper that I hereby resign the presidency, effective immediately. Elections will be held next Tuesday. If you need anything in the meantime, Big Pete's got it covered. Ain't that right, Big Pete?
Yeah, right on.
His number is, do you have your pencil ready? You'll just take it down on your phones. Kids these days. His number is 884-631-5823. That's 884-631-5823. Give him a call if you need anything. There's leftovers in the fridge. Give Lucy a walk when you get home from school. But really, you don't have to listen to any of that, because I've already abdicated all authority as president of Latvia. Thank you. Good night.
Meanwhile, later in the play, we learned that just a few months later, outside the purview of this year's theatrical action, the president of Latvia really did attempt to resign, but found that, for whatever reason, the words wouldn't work. That even though he said again and again, I resign, on the toilet, in the shower, on first dates, in text messages, no matter what, he was still the president of Latvia. He couldn't shake it. The presidency had become like a metaphor for something that won't leave you alone.
So, I really think we're making great progress. I say as I walk down the laboratory hallway here in the great state of New Jersey with my assistant, Anna Calupia.
Red skin, be quiet.
And I throw these baby browns up to that hungry little camera part to get these kitties scanned. And every time I do this, I feel like a million ducks, because I know I got the baddest retinas in town. These babies turn heads at Geoff's Bar and Grill, picked me up a mighty amount of tail with these little workers, got them rods and cones in flawless alignment. Like Michelangelo made him himself. The Ninja Turtle, not the painter. So I swing him into the scan doohickey and...
Access. Grandfather. Welcome back, St. Crispin's Day Massacre.
Good to be back, motherfucker! or was it rollerblading?
And how one day when she was 14 or 23, in the middle of the competition, her wheel fell off. Or was it her blade got twisted? And she fell on her face or her ass and killed every one of her teeth. Or killed everyone in attendance. And so that in a couple of weeks' time, or just a few minutes, she had a mouth full of black and rotted teeth, not broken, just dead. Or was it a stadium full of dead and rotted people? Who knows? But irregardlessly, and here's the part of the story where the triumph of the human spirit really plays out, she still goes every Sunday or Tuesday to the roller rink or ice capades to spin triple axles and rip figure eights with her two sister wives, or are they just sisters? Anna Pest and Anna Fora, or maybe they're just best friends and they feel like they're sisters, unless they're like one of those families where all the girls get the same first name and it's the middle one that's really the signifier. But every Friday or Wednesday, at the roller rink or dog pound, you can find the three of them, fiber optic joints and all, twisting and flipping and generally kicking bum, triumphing triumphantly over justified fears, fears that stem from rather horrific skate-related accidents for the each of them.
If you can't get back on the horse, then why the fuck did you fall off it in the first place?
And in fact, at this point, a team of 78 stagehands replaces the set for public gallows with a skate rink, or ice rink, Zamboni, and everything. It's really quite a production. And we watch these three women, beautiful of spirit, do some freaking kick-a freaking skate moves. Wow! Zowie! Would you take a look at that? Until Lee finally shows up again, the rink disappears in a puff of smoke and mirrors, and we continue with our regularly scheduled dramatic action, now informed and enheartened by our in-depth knowledge of the secret inner life of one of our peripheral characters who knows, just may become the hero of our story, said the woman with the robot voice.
I have a rich and complex backstory, too. I'm a person, too, and I ought to, as a person, too, be treated as such. I was born in Siberia. That nugget and shoved it up in the face. And my parents never bought me a single toy. My brothers and I played with sticks. Sticks! And most of the time, we didn't even have sticks. Because Papa needed them all for firewood. Because we needed fires. So we could be warm. Because Siberia is cold as brick. So don't paint me as some needy, whiny, oh no, are you gonna come back? I love you. Lame-o. Because I am strong. Strong as fudge. And I don't take no naps for nobody. So carry on if you want, but keep that spit in mind for a moment. Hey, another thing? Listen. It doesn't matter that I made all that up. And the only way I know where Siberia is from playing Risk, the game of global domination from Parker Brothers. But yeah, I mean, whatever. Give me my due. Hey.
As we walked in, fresh from the gym, he made a particular point of resting his big Jersey knuckles on the back of his big Jersey head. Oh, so so that his big Jersey pits could hit the bigger Jersey air to maximum effect, stinking up the place with his big Jersey pheromones. Nearby, a castrated rat achieved multiple orgasms, and a colony of ants devouring their queen stopped all productive labor and engaged in a Bacchic orgy, the unspeakable depravity of which would make your grandmother puke blood.
You can put your pits down, it ain't doing the trick.
Said St. Crispin's Day Massacre in the Big Jersey Left.
Shut up your ass, Marn. Flap crap the Wazzle.
Wazzle is flap cracked.
Boondoggle the Boodleheimer.
Boodleheimer, boondoggle.
Organizations or persons.
Ace?